Hello racing fans and a warm welcome to Trackside, proudly brought to you by World Sports Betting. Bet with the best, bet with WSB, a leader in the fixed odds betting market and number one, as always, numero uno in the anti-post betting market. What's happening this weekend? Local racing, doubleheader on Saturday, Kenilworth and Tiffentine, and then we move over to Greyville on Sunday. It's sport to follow this weekend. Two trebles will be up on your World Sports Betting menu. And away we go with the four horses this weekend. We'll begin at Tiffentine on Saturday, and the first of our four runners will come up in race number three. And this is a daughter of Captain of All, horse number four. Her name is From Here to Eternity. And her solid form from May last season has continued into this season. Our last seven runs, she's had two wins and four places. And when you look at her last three starts, it's worth touching on. Three runs back, she was a facile winner, very easy winner at the Vaal over 1400 meters with jockey Lyle Hewitson. And of course, Lyle Hewitson, well, he's no more in South Africa. He jetted off on Wednesday to start his international campaign in Hong Kong. And we wish him all the best. You know, he's been there before, didn't work out as he wanted to, but we're hoping and fingers crossed that he can certainly get the job done in Hong Kong this time round. So all the best, Lyle, on behalf of World Sports Betting. Then we move along to the penultimate run with From Here to Eternity, and that day she moved down to KZN and she raced in a competitive field, but I was expecting her to go pretty close to winning it that day. If you watch that replay, she was so awkward in the latter stages of the race. She was hanging in over the final 200 meters. And nevertheless, she ran a good race. And then back home last time out at the Vaal, they dropped her in distance 1200 meters. They put the blinkers on and she was close up. She tried hard that day, but she found one better when she was beaten by I Dream of Jeannie. Looking at that last start, the handicapper did penalize her for running second from a 77 to a 79. So what that basically means, it cost her, you know, a kg less in this race. But when I analyze her form and have a look at her profile, I just feel that she's capable of achieving higher than her current rating of 79. And she's drawn one. She's from an informed stable and a combination of Paul Peter and Warren Kennedy. I think she'll have the run of the race and I'm expecting her to be the filly to beat. Race number three, horse number four, From Here to Eternity. Then we move along to race number eight, and this is a Pinnacle Stakes over 1160 meters. And here we have a horse that caught the imagination from day one. Yes, from day one is a horse that many of us penciled in as one to follow after he won by a street at the Vaal over 1,000 meters. He was in a race of his own. His name is Al Sakit, his horse number two. He followed that up with another good win in Graduation Company. And then the stable raced him in the Group 3 Man O' War Sprint. I expected him to pretty much win that. He ran a good race, but it wasn't him on the day. I firmly feel that was not his run. He was third, and next two starts, well, he put that run behind him, winning in fine style. And then his last start to close off his three-year-old campaign, it was on the last day of last season. He took his place. He was thrown in the deep end in the Mercury Sprint. And what an absolute blinder it was. It was a three-year-old with a rating of 106. And from draw, 12 out of 14, he set second to last for most of the way. But when his mind was on the job over the final 300 meters or so, he absolutely flew to run second behind winner Pearl of Asia. That was a fantastic run to close off his three-year-old campaign. And it's worth noting that the results of that Mercury Sprint was dominated by two horses that were at the bottom of the ratings, that Pearl of Asia and this three-year-old then Al Sakit. But the Formline has since held up very well. MK's Pride has since gone on to win his next two starts, and one of those wins was in the Joburg Spring Challenge. And last weekend he ran a decent third in the Honor Mission Mile, and a subsequent winner from that Formline as well, a horse called Shantyman, winning at Greyville. So the Formline's looking good. And when I look at this individual, I have no doubt that he is going to be one of the leading sprinters this season. And I'm hoping that he starts off his four-year-old campaign with a bang. That's horse number two, Al Sakit. Then we go on to race number two at Greyville. We're moving along to Sunday now. And a clear standout here is horse number three, Gaudi's Masterpiece. It's a maiden plate over 1200 meters. Gaudi's Masterpiece, first two runs in Cape Town, fifth and a close up second. He then qualified for the Bloodstock South Africa bonus races, and he took his place on Vodacom Durban July Day in the Bloodstock South Africa Cup, and he got very close. It was a great run behind a horse that's highly thought of by the Astley Fortune Stable called Bard of Avon. After that run, it was staked into a Group 1, the Premier's Champion Stakes, and he wasn't disgraced behind the winner, Good Traveller. He was beaten four lengths. Now that form line is powerful. All of William Robertson, Waterbury Lane, Pasta Manana, and Quantum King have all come out to win. And then last time out, I mentioned he qualifies for those Bloodstock South Africa bonus races. He travelled up to Gauteng, and he took his place in that Bloodstock South Africa Cup. It was a good run, considering that he had to do traveling, etc. Finished fourth behind William Robinson. So that's his form line. Now, with a rating of 96, he is the highest rated maiden three-year-old in the country. And with that rating of 96 against this maiden field, I mentioned at the top of this preview of this horse that he's a clear standout. Well, he is, and he will be very hard to oppose. Number three, Gaudi's Masterpiece. And then the last of our four runners will come up in race number four, and that will be horse number five, Red Soul from the Dennis Dreyer stable, who's had four starts. His first two runs, he actually started off his career up in Gauteng. And his first two starts, well, he flopped badly. He was no show in Gauteng. The stable gave him the time off, gelded on the 1st of February, and he's had three runs back home after the rest and gelding for 3 seconds. Second, close up to safe return. Second, good run behind Sia Vuma. And in his last start, I'm going to touch on that run because they pushed him over furlong further to 1600 meters, and he was traveling smoothly to out. He was traveling like a winner, Red Soul. And then when they moved into the straight and Tristan Godden decided to make his run, himself and the third place runner got pretty close in the running, and both horses started to shift in towards the inside of the track. And while all that was happening between Tenacious Time and Red Soul, it was a clear run up on the outside for Royal Monarch, who won a good race. But nevertheless, Red Soul did run well, finishing second. That form line has seen Royal Monarch follow up on that maiden win. The third place runner, Tenacious Time, winning his maiden next time out. So that form line's looking good, it's looking bright, and it's looking good. Horse number five, Red Soul. And whilst there is some form to go around amongst a few of the runners in the race, I think he looks to have found the right type of field for him, number five, Red Soul, to be rewarded for his consistency. So those are the four horses, and how are we going to play it? Well, it is going to be from here to eternity into Al Sakit, into Gaudi's Masterpiece. That will be treble number one, and then treble number two will be Al Sakit on Saturday at Turfantine, into the two horses on Sunday at Greyville. That's Gaudi's Masterpiece and Red Soul. And that is a wrap of our Trackside episode for this weekend, brought to you by World Sports Betting. And on behalf of World Sports Betting, thanks to all the punters, but more importantly and more especially, thanks to you, the valued customer. Until next week, enjoy your weekend's racing, find all the winners, and hopefully these four horses, all four, arrive and we crack both trebles, which will be up on the World Sports Betting menu. As always, you can shop around, but I guarantee you won't find any price comparable to the boosted odds for these two trebles on World Sports Betting. Until next week, you take care. Salanigashte.